shade, of course. Vehicles only. Wow. Cool. What a photo album this is. Oh my goodness. Wow. This is amazing. Wow. This is incredible. There's John's Greek and Mills. Wow.
Yeah. start off. Makes a lot of noise.
Yeah, they were pretty loud in the day.
I bet you they were.
They said that when the big one was running up here, you could hear it for miles around.
Huh.
A lot of people would figure out how to get back down to town just by listening to the where the mill was at. Yeah, it was pretty crazy. Well, I'm sure these had an explanation at one time. Obviously, these are grinding stones.
So it was you guys moving in the Air Force. You were like, was that marriage or was that her childhood she's talking about?
Yeah, we moved. But we didn't move as much as a lot of people moved.
Pretty fascinating. Thank you. hard to believe it, that this was a huge stamp mill. Built in like 1880, 1881. Been here a while. That is the original structure. I'll get up as close as I can to it. It's quite a structure. As you can see, it's had some snow loads on it that are pretty much stressing it out. It's got bracing all over the inside, there's cables, but there's a lot of the original stuff still sitting in there from way back in the day. But they gotta keep everybody out of it because it's unsafe dinner. Take a look at this picture right here. Look at those houses. Everybody's completely buried. So back in the heyday, Eureka Mills, this place that we're at here, high up in here in the mountainside, was primarily a family town. Jameson City, which is down near the creek, was the place for single miners to live. The mountainside took on quite a village appearance. There were two stores, a hotel with a saloon, two other saloons, a bootmaker's shop, livery stable, and a few dwellings. People would often ride the empty ore carts back up the mountain to the town site. After completion of the Mohawk Mill, which is what we're looking at now, so I've seen these things out in the woods and wondered what they were. I thought they were some sort of a compressor of some sort, but it's strictly air to run the pneumatic drills, I'm sure.
going to draw names of the 19s and plus.
Hi. Actual blacksmithing. Well, I would say that's all there is to see here. It's pretty cool. Not quite as much as I thought there was going to be, but very cool nonetheless. Definitely worth a trip. This is a pretty cool spot.